Thank you very much. As I was being a former field artilleryman, as I was watching that jet go over top, I kind of remember why I like it, everything so loud. If you were at our CA party last night, you'll understand that's a very close tie-in. So thank you very much. This is my first keynote at RSA. So go easy on the little evaluation cards. Be gentle. I'm really excited today to talk to you about an organization that I think is doing really good things, that CA is a big part of, but really it's the member organizations. So you're not going to hear a lot of a product pitch today, and you're going to hear a lot about an example of an organization that's done some really good things around collaboration, around identity management, around secure email, and the secure trade of information. The organization is called TSCP, and it stands for Transglobal Secure Collaboration Platform. And I'm very excited to you to talk to you a little bit about it today. So we've talked a little bit about the operational benefits of the clouds if you've listened to some of the other presenters. But really what I'm here to talk to you today about is the power of collaboration. In particular, the power of knowing. It's knowing who you're working with, what access they have, what role they play in that organization, and what they should really be working on. As an example, I like to go to the gaming. I know gaming, online gaming, is a big part of many of the people in this room and your everyday lives. And a particular example that I enjoy, it's legendary in the last several years, online gaming World of Warcraft, where the organization and several members came together several hours inside this online game. They're about to go into a critical element of the overall attack. They've calculated the success or failure down to 33.33, repeating, of course, the opportunity for success or failure. And I don't know if anybody has caught on exactly who it is. You know who I'm talking about? Heck yeah, it's Leroy Jenkins! If you don't know, go on YouTube, 25 million hits, it's a big deal, and you know, it's a real good example of collaboration in action. And it's an example of maybe what not to do. They should have done a better job of verifying who he was. He was who he says you are. So maybe two-factor authentication for gaming, who knows. So with that, I'd like to introduce a little bit more of the organization of TSCP. As an organization, it has 23 member organizations. It's a global organization, so it's both US and non-US. It involves enterprises, technology companies, organizations that make hard goods, and they really are doing things right about sharing information. So with that, instead of me explaining fully exactly what TSCP does, I have a brief video that I'd like to share with you.
Balancing the need to share critical information with the obligation to prevent it from falling into the wrong hands is one of the greatest challenges the aerospace and defense industry faces today.
As technology accelerates the pace of business, it's critical that industry and government partners work together to develop and employ better ways to share data securely.
The potential of business collaboration too often goes unrealized. Standalone solutions are expensive, they don't scale properly, and they can't effectively protect the information and identities of aligned parties.
The purpose of TSCP is to foster an environment where resources converge to develop and adopt better, stronger, more agile electronic business specifications that deliver robust security measures across our global membership community.
Data security breaches, identity theft, these are issues that are not going away. We realized early on that rather than battle them alone, it made more sense to pool the talent and resources of government and industry partners to develop sustainable security measures that we can roll out across pre-existing business channels.
TSCP members jointly author real-world business security solutions. Members can share highly sensitive data with confidence, knowing that it is protected and that the person on the other side of the conversation truly is who they say they are.
When you join the TSCP community, you enter a virtual circle of trust where industry partners gain direct access to government projects while government agencies get a best-of-breed product generated by the greatest minds in the business.
As more critical defense business is done online, TSCP members will carry the most prized status in the industry, recognition as a trusted business partner.
Super, thank you. Now let me take the time to introduce the members of my panel. As you'll see from that video, they've been instrumental at pulling this all together, and we're going to give you a little bit of an insight of how it came to be, what problems it solved, and what kind of benefit they've seen from more secure collaboration and a transglobal, very complicated IT supply chain. So first, let me introduce Keith Ward. Keith is the Director of Enterprise Security and Identity Management at Northrop Grumman. He's a recognized expert in security and identity management and has led the remediation for cybersecurity advanced persistent threats at Northrop Grumman. Currently, Keith serves as the chairman of the Transglobal Secure Collaboration Program. Please welcome Keith.
Hey, Mike. Thanks. Thank you.
Next, I have Michael Daly, the director of IT security at the Raytheon Company. 25 years in cybersecurity, Michael's responsibilities range from global information security policy, cyber intelligence and analysis, and network and data protections. Thank you. Next, we have Philippe Laflandre from EADS. He's the vice president and head of EADS Corporate Trust Center, 30 years in the private and public companies. Today, he leads EADS Corporate Trust Center within the Cybersecurity Center for EADS. And he's the incoming chair of TSCP.
Yes, good, Mike.
Thank you. Finally, we have Tim Brown. Tim is near and dear to my heart in the CA Technologies with me. I consider him my chief security architect, and he's a distinguished engineer. He really leads the overall technical direction for CA Technologies around security products, in particular, identity and access management. Welcome.
Thanks, Mike.
Thanks. Okay. Slide down one. So now we're going to go through a little bit, gentlemen, of kind of question and answer. We've talked a little bit about this that can help educate the audience here at RSA about some of the things they can do around collaboration, identity management, and those things that can help speed integration and how security can really become an enabler for better business agility. So let me start with Keith. There's a lot of communities today, Keith, that are coming together in the industry. Can you talk a little bit about how TSCP came together?
Yes, Mike. And this is our ninth year for TSCP, so that's a long time, yes. But TSCP is a government industry partnership that was formed in 2002 by some of the leading aerospace and defense companies, together with the UK Ministry of Defense and the US Department of Defense. I think the intro really explained what TSCP, I always like that vignette. Mike, you referenced our membership, 23 companies, and it makes me think that maybe the best way to describe TSCP is with maybe three fun facts. And so one of those first fun facts that we look at, when you look at a membership of 23 members, what does that represent? Well, for TSCP, that represents 25% of Microsoft's global sales. In fact, according to Microsoft, we are the largest single customer voice. The second is investment. When you look at our companies over the last several years, when we're talking about remediation of cyber threats, we have spent literally, collectively, hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars to secure our enterprises, as well as put the enabling capabilities to allow access to our portals for our suppliers and to our customers. The third is really our supply chain. And when you start looking at collaboration as what was in the vignette, and when I look here with Raytheon with Mike, and we talk about some of the electronic surveillance programs that we have, or with our partner over here with EADS, with Eurohawk or Globalhawk, and I have to give mention to BAE and Boeing and Lockheed, where we all collectively work on the F-16, F-18, F-22, and Joint Strike Fighter. To put that in magnitude is about 300,000 supplier companies that we collectively work together on those programs.
So basically, everyone from the wingnut manufacturer to the most sophisticated electronic component on your complicated systems.
That's correct.
So I appreciate the hard work going in that, having flown in some of those aircraft before. The reliability is critical. So a little bit, Mike, if you can explain a little bit, I think people would like to know kind of the early genesis of the organization. What is it that brought, usually there's a carrot and there's a stick, there's something that is an incentive to do this, but there's also a threat. Can you talk about that?
Sure. Yeah, when we got started back in 2002, we had two activities going on. One, we knew that we needed to secure our e-business operations. And so we had one group going on in the UK called the UK CEB. It's an e-business organization. And then on the US side, we had a company that we stood up as a joint venture called Exostar, which is a business-to-business exchange. And that was driven so that we would have a secure supply chain environment to buy and sell components. When we finished the Exostar project and we looked at the threats that our companies were facing at that time, with UK CEB and other groups, we decided not to waste that energy that we had, where we started to collaborate and we realized that in not every circumstance are we going to be competitors. We can actually find some common ground. In fact, more than that, it was absolutely crucial that we did, because we were spending a lot of energy standing up a new program every single time and reestablishing the rules for how we were going to exchange information. We would have to start with new legal contracts every single time and define what is a password. When we say you have to secure this information, well, what do you mean in your company? And so that's what brought us to bring TSCP together, to establish those rules so that we could handle the information and move it between our companies and our governments.
Super. I know, Philippe, you have a different perspective maybe coming from the other side of the Atlantic. Talked a little bit about how, from a European perspective, you saw this organization come together.
Well, we were a part of that UK initiative that Mike just mentioned. And but, you know, the core of why we joined and were very active from the very beginning is that we share exactly the same, you know, base of suppliers, you know, around this TSCP circle of trust. So you don't want to reinvent the wheel each time. You want to enroll a new supplier who is working for one of the other company. So that's a very important factor. And it's not for non-profit that we are working, so we are looking at economy of scale. And for us, it's very obvious that if we establish, you know, several different standard for collaboration, it's going to be a nightmare. So we just want to share the same specification. And, you know, TSCP, this is what it's all about. We are heavily competing with one another, but we want to be sure that we can trust each other, and for that, you know, it's paramount. The other point that I want to stress is the lead time in the programs. You know, the extended enterprise is what is, you know, the characteristic of what we do. What is core is basically 20% that you want to keep inside the company, and the rest you have to outsource. So the extended enterprise must be something that facilitates and reduces the lead time versus extended it. So you need that kind of collaborative approach. And this is what we are looking for from the early, you know, beginning.
Yeah, super. One of the things I'll ask Tim to comment from an enterprise perspective as well, but one of the things that struck me as I was talking with this group is really oftentimes they're competitors in the morning and they're collaborators in the afternoon. So a lot of challenges around access control, but maybe Tim, you can elaborate a little bit more about how some other enterprise are tackling these challenges or see these challenges around collaboration.
Yeah, thanks, Mike. I mean, when we look at enterprises, you know, enterprises are a little bit behind the defense industry. You know, the defense industry has had to do major collaborations for a great deal of time, right? You know, Keith mentioned 300,000 different partners. So when they do, you know, build an aircraft carrier, 30,000, 40,000, 50,000 partners is common. You know, when we look at enterprises looking at today trying to collaborate with hundreds and then moving to thousands. But collaboration is not any longer just an option. Collaboration is a necessity for the business. So as we were looking at this at CA, trying to figure out, well, how do we help our enterprises collaborate better? How do we help them do something in a more organized fashion? How do we help them do something in a repeatable fashion? You know, we found TSCP, who had already built a lot of this framework that we can utilize in many parts of, you know, enterprises as well as the defense organizations.
Super. Now kind of turning on to specifically the security challenges, and Philippe, I'll direct this to you. What were some of the specific security challenges you were trying to overcome, and what maybe are some takeaways that the audience here can take from as they're trying to set up maybe a collaborative environment, a partnered extranet, anything where you have organizations, entities, individuals sharing information? Talk a little bit of that, if you will.
Right. You know, what is the biggest lesson learned as far as, you know, my company is concerned is alignment of the different, you know, major functions that are that have to be aligned and that have been, you know, from culturally point of view, not working together that well. You know, I'm talking about HR, security, and IT. I'm sorry to say that all we're talking about has nothing to do with IT, almost, just a joke. But it's about alignment of processes, you know, getting those guys working together. How can you trust the HR department in the recruitment period? Are you sure that the guy at the booth at the entrance of your facility in security operation talks to the security IT? And all of those guys should give good requirements to the IT community of their company. So unless you do that very cumbersome job, nothing will work because identity management cannot exist. So, you know, tunnel effect is the biggest enemy in this endeavor. You have to stay for a long month just investing, just aligning people. You can't see anything. And then maybe if you're still alive 3 years later, you know, you can see the benefit. So lessons learned, it's got to be corporate driven. You know, nobody in operation or in sales or whatever can decide to do that kind of a job. It's got to be strategic. And you've got to invest in developing an infrastructure, but then think about deployment. If you don't think about deployment, you know, you can throw the whole thing.
That's a good point. Maybe, Tim, you could comment a little bit more about that. All that early work up front sounds to be a big element of the success there. And it also sounds like buy-in up and down the organization and up and down the corporation to make sure that everybody is bought into the investment required to get this off the ground, so long as you can maybe prove out the ROI at the end, right?
Comment. Yeah, absolutely. So enabling the trust, right, in all of your collaborative partners, understanding what they're doing, understanding, you know, what identity systems they have in place, how they're assigning rights and attributes to each one of their users. Now, identity is core. And, you know, ensuring that the right people have the right access to the right data at the right time in a fashion that's auditable, right, is absolutely necessary in these collaborative environments. And the frameworks help to do that. They help to set the tone necessary to be able to enable that environment.
Super. So, Michael, back to you a little bit on this. Raytheon Company is very complicated, large organization. Maybe what are some of the other industries could take away from not just aerospace and defense, lessons learned from setting up a secure collaboration environment, an organization like TSCP?
Yeah, the principles that we have in TSCP, I think, apply to all businesses. I mean, we have our own specific issues around international traffic and arms regulation, so we focus a lot on export control.
Yeah, but nothing like ITAR and potentially going to jail to motivate people to action. I think
exactly. The $1 million fine and personally going to jail is a big motivator. But every industry has their own set of regulations, and that's why I think it is quite transportable. And the key features, the requirements we brought into TSCP carry across. So strong identity management is absolutely key. Identifying your data and data labeling is important. Information handling requirements and setting up the legal framework so that your partners know what to do when they receive the information, that's critical. All of these things, the federated identity management techniques, that all carries over. And so I think that, you know, I think everyone could benefit from tscp.org and checking it out.
Super.
I should add, you know, TSCP isn't a club or an organization that, you know, you go off and join. It's actually a group of us who are investing money to solve a common problem. That's what we're here for in TSCP.
Yeah, we're pleased to be part of that as an organization. I think that As we shift, you've gotten a little bit about the genesis of TSCP. You've got a little bit about kind of the early, how they set up this organization to be successful and kind of the diligence that Philippe pointed out of the stick-to-itiveness, buy-in, and the early work that you need to do up front. We talked a little bit so far from Mike about getting exactly how this can translate across other industries. Now, shift a little bit now to you, Keith. Can you give us some real examples, hard case studies, that where you've gained efficiencies, a return on investment, if you will, for investing in a collaborative process?
Yes, just to follow up on Mike, I think the best way that I like to describe TSEP is, for us, is more like a joint research and development together. Mm-hmm. That we put equity in, we're putting in-kind services in, and what's more important, I think, for a takeaway for this audience is that, and I will describe the two notables, but we publish our specifications with the hope, the understanding that you'll take these specifications and you put them into your product roadmaps that we can then buy through the acquisition cycle. Mm-hmm. So that's the basic understanding when we talk about a private partnership with the government, and our specifications are out there on the website. So the two that I think are, and there's many of them, but the two that I think are the most notable for us is our secure email specification, and secure email for some of us that have implemented that within our company is really about reducing the threat vector. We developed this under Microsoft Exchange, spent many years, a lot of dollars, but recently a federal agency that just wanted to put their toe in the water with TSEP, they took that specification and they were able to implement it with Lotus Notes within about a month. We provided some services to help them that also helped us how to do our how-to guide to make it a little easier for anybody else. Raytheon is a Lotus Note shop, so that worked out very well. And then the second specification, which was really a testament to the hard work that we have been doing over the years, was what the engineers refer to it as DSIF, but our Data Sharing Information Federation specification, really allowing each one of us to have access to our portals with credentials. Those could be the Common Access Card, the PIV card, the PIV-I card, or any other medium level of assurance coming in, not only to access applications, but also with attributes to access data and information. That specification was developed under Microsoft Exchange. When CA Technologies came on board, one of the first things that they did is they immediately ported that specification to their flagship product, SiteMinder, mm-hmm. which we were happy at Northrop Grumman because since we're a SiteMinder shop, and again, mm-hmm. there's something here to this, Mike, at Raytheon is a SiteMinder shop as well. But the takeaway from that is that's exactly what we're looking for. We're looking for those specifications to be put into your product roadmap so that we can either sell through to our companies or out to our customer base or out to the supply chain. And I think those two are probably the most notable in really looking at hard, tangible things that helped us in remediation of cyber threats as well as collaboration amongst all of these programs.
Yeah, right. maybe the good takeaway there is a lesson learned for vendors that might be in the audience is that kind of the long-term investment made in this collaborative environment can really help guide your roadmap to be exactly where it needs to be for your organization as the specification develops.
Yeah, and when you think about the cost savings that you can get from this, I mean, when you see a Raytheon employee with Raytheon credentials and a Raytheon PIV card be able to authenticate to one of these partner sites and be able to access that sensitive application, I mean, think of all the infrastructure that you just saved. Think about the site time savings that you did. You have a trust model that actually works between competitors. Mm-hmm. And their partners on a certain product, and they can get to that application with their own credentials. I mean, it's just an amazing efficiency gain.
Super. Yeah, Tim, so that'll kind of shifts us into our last section here of our discussion here, and it's specifically around the cloud. So, if Tim, maybe you could talk a little bit, and I'd like the whole panel to comment on this, because it is a very important topic, cloud security, collaboration. What are some of the key points, takeaways that you got from involvement in the TSCP?
So when we look at the cloud, everybody's talking about the cloud this week, right? And within the cloud, we see, collaboration everywhere. It's really a collaboration medium. And in that model, we need to be able to do things that are repeatable, right? We need to be able to log into a cloud application the same way over and over again for each one of these partners. We need to be able to do it securely. We need to be able to transfer data in a secure fashion that's actually going to, you know, have guarantees associated with that transfer and the access to applications. So what the TSCP has done in a non-cloud world, bringing together all of the defense industries and, you know, huge amounts of huge projects that they're doing, that is a great example for us to utilize when we start moving towards the cloud, right? The frameworks that they've produced, the specifications that they've produced, you know, fit exactly towards as where we're going towards cloud.
Philippe, maybe you can comment.
Yeah, I think what is absolutely key for us from now on is to have that scalability installed, you know, starting from what we have developed, which represent, as Keith was explaining, a lot of money. So we absolutely need to scale that down in quality and in quantity. Quality for me means that we make all those specifications affordable for the small and medium business, because this is where, you know, the big money is at the end of the day for us and for them all together. So that's one. And, you know, in numbers, we have to make sure that things scale properly in very diverse environment, because what we see inside our enterprise, but right at the next circle for the tier number one, you know, in the supply chain, is that when you want to, you know, adapt that trust fabric to their environment, you need to do some kind of effort. And now we should focus on that.
Great insights. Mike, comments?
Yeah, the TSCP work, I think, maps perfectly and directly to the cloud, because that's actually what we were trying to do. When we collaborate to build that warship, Northrop is going to do a piece, and EADS is going to do a piece, and Lockheed's going to do a piece, and so on. And each has their own services that they need to run. What we needed to have happen is strongly verified credentials pass from one company to another company, because otherwise we have to have those people go run down the street and visit the other site and get a new set of credentials. That trusting party would not know if we had terminated that person. They're not going to get that phone call to everyone that person may have ever done business with in their life. So we need those credentials to be instantaneously terminated across the entire defense industry. And so I think the cloud faces these same kinds of issues. How are identities strongly vetted, asserted in hardware credentials? How do we protect information, encrypt it at the data point, make sure that it's labeled correctly, that it's handled properly through its lifetime? That is exactly what we're trying to accomplish, and that is the challenge of cloud.
That's a great, great segue to cloud. Keith, any comments on kind of cloud that you can add to those three?
Well, a few. I'm pretty excited about the cloud. At times, I don't think my management is as excited as I am, yeah. I'll describe that. I was in a recent meeting, and my boss had said, if you really understand how to implement a cloud service, your hair would turn right. And I said, I don't have that problem. So, but the reason I'm excited about it, or we're collectively excited about it, is because in our little ecosystem that we have within TSCP, we have three alignments that have come together for us. And the first is on the economic side. You know, we have a return on investment. As I indicated, we've spent hundreds and hundreds of millions of dollars collectively. And we didn't do that without having the proper business case there, the value proposition and the return on investment. The second, and I think everyone knows this in doing this, is really around the governance or the trust framework. And for us within TSCP, we stood up our own PKI service, which is called CertiPath. And so that has a cross-certification to the federal bridge. For some of our companies, we have a direct bilateral trust with DOD, and we have a legal framework agreement, the governance structure that we've all signed together, and that gives us pretty much the operating component. And the last piece is the technology, and that really refers to what really makes TSCP different is that we have real requirements from real programs. That's what we bring to the table. And those are used to generate these requirements, these specifications, these how-to guides, as well as specifications that are, you know, typically inherent in these large-scale collaborative programs, and especially when they cross national jurisdictions. Yep. So for a cloud model, when everyone says, but what is it? I think we have it. What we need, because one thing that we all know, and this is the entire membership, there isn't one country, there isn't one government, there isn't one agency, or there isn't one defense contractor that can solve these problems alone. We've realized that early on.
And, by definition, that's collaboration.
That's
right?
Collaboration. That's what we need is help. We need help in these areas to make this happen.
Super. So let me, with some of the time we have left, let me kind of jump to our final question, Tim, and a little bit about how do you deal with the various personas? You know, I think what's a big challenge if you start to look at the complexity of identity management and you, as you talked about going from one to the other, knowing when to remove one, or maybe they have a different role in a different organization and should have access to different information. Talk a little bit about that as it relates to TSCP technically and how some lessons learned that the audience here today could take away as best practices around that.
So. You know, at CA Technologies, we're really focused on looking at how we can build our products for secure collaboration and how we can implement these frameworks that TSCP had provided. So we took our products and our product sets and, in a short matter of time, we were able to move those products into this framework. So, you know, as Keith mentioned, we use our SiteMinder product to do web access management, our SiteMinder family to do federation. We used that same technology to do SOAS security. And one of the key components here is also data leakage protection and being able to understand from an identity perspective who should have access to what. Making sure that we can take an identity view of DLP and be able to say that, you know, since Tim Brown works at CA, he is looking at a certain program which he has access to, he can now access that data. But it has to be on an individual basis. It can't be on simply that, you know, the data fits this certain format or this certain signature. It really needs to be at the person level, so the identity level, and be able to understand through that process that, you know, I should have access to that specific application, that specific piece of data. So, you know, as Keith said, the two programs for data sharing and for information sharing, they rely on having appropriate access, and they rely on having appropriate access to data through intelligence. And, you know, that's what we really provide.
Super. So, you know, that's great insight, especially near and dear to a lot of folks here. I think insider threat is really the thing that you highlighted there, and
absolutely,
that as you give out access, you need to go through the diligence there of finding out what roles, what access to that data, and then making sure they only have access to the data they're supposed to have. So I'd like to thank the panel today for sharing your insights. It's been very helpful, and as you can see, collaboration is going to provide better business results without actually increasing your business risk. I think we provided some really good insights in return on investment of how better work up front, how better understanding of identity, how better understanding of secure sharing of information can help you with the power of no. So we here at CA are very thankful for your time today. I would like to invite you to come to our booth, visit, talk a little bit more about secure collaboration, and thank you very much for your time today.